I appreciate your piece too. It was incredibly honest because, you know, people like me who did not grow up, I didn't have anybody that served. I mean, my husband's relatives were imprisoned in the Caribbean as part of the Union. So we didn't have anybody that was in the Confederacy in the Civil War. And so I've always looked at the flag, I guess, from, even though I'm from Missouri, from the Ozarks, from, I guess, a Yankee point of view, for the lack of a better way to put it. Tell me the significance of the Confederate flag for your family personally, because everyone, when they see it, they're like, oh, well, that's just a, they basically say it's a tramp stamp for racism. I have no idea how to put it. Well, give me your thoughts on this.
Well, you know, I grew up, I had a American flag in my room and I had a Confederate flag in my room. And the reason why I had a Confederate flag in my room was the same reason that I had an American flag in my room, is that we had a legacy of service, of military service on my family that went all the way back to Valley Forge. Now, during the Civil War, that military service was for the Confederacy. There were officers in my family who served at Shiloh, at Vicksburg, at the battles of Franklin and Nashville. You could go to my grandmother's house, and there would be my great-great-grandfather still in his Confederate uniform, even in the late 19th century. Every time he'd be photographed in that uniform. And I grew up learning about that history from the standpoint of military courage, of valor in the field. And that was something that meant a lot to me. Much later in life, you know, when you're not a young kid, you grow up and you learn a lot more about history and all its complexity. But that's what I grew up with, was hearing the stories of members of my family who fought on those terrible battlefields.
Right. The Disney Epcot, they have an American museum that they allow tours to go through. And they have all of the flags of the United States on display because they tell the story of our country at one point in time. And they had until very recently the Confederate flag displayed, and then they removed that, which I thought, well, that doesn't make the Civil War, it doesn't make racism or slavery or disagreement disappear. It just ignores history.
Right, it makes us more ignorant is what it does. And that's one of my problems with this latest wave of controversy about the flag. Look, if the flag is flying from a Capitol building, the way, you know, the Democrats put it there in the 1960s in South Carolina as a symbol of defending segregation, we'll take that down. That's just a pure symbol of white supremacy. If it is a symbol, if it's being flown at a battlefield, if it's being flown at a memorial for Confederate soldiers, then it's much more a part of history. It's that thing that we teach our kids about. Why did this happen? How did this happen? How was this fought? Why that flag? Why does it look like that? These are all questions that matter to history.
Right.
And just taking down flags doesn't change our history. It just means we know less about it.